Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about restriction enzymes. Now the content which comes under this topic are introduction about restriction enzyme, discovery, how restriction enzymes work, type of restriction enzyme, subunit of restriction enzyme, nomenclature of restriction enzyme, recognition sequence of restriction enzyme, properties and applications of restriction enzyme. Restriction endonucleases are enzymes that produce internal cut called cleavage in DNA molecule. Restriction endonuclease is a bacterial enzyme that cut double-stranded DNA into fragment after recognizing specific nucleotide sequence known as recognition or restriction site. The restriction enzymes are believed to be evolved by bacteria to resist viral attack. Restriction enzymes are also known as molecular scissors. Discovery of restriction enzyme. The term restriction enzyme originated from the study of phage lambda. In 1960, it was shown by Warner, Matthew, Meselson, but they studied only about type 1 restriction enzyme. In 1970, Hamilton, Thomas, Kent isolated and characterized the first type 2 restriction enzyme, that is HIND2, from the bacterium Haemophilus influenza. For their work in the discovery and characterization of restriction enzyme, the 1978 Nobel Prize for Physiology or Medicine was awarded to Warner, Daniel and Hamilton. Now the restriction enzymes are categorized into three groups. One is type 1, 2, 3 restriction endonucleases. Categorization of restriction enzymes on the basis of their composition, enzyme cofactor requirement, the nature of their target sequence, position of their DNA cleavage site relative to the target sequence. How restriction endonucleases work. Restriction enzymes recognize specific sequence of nucleotide and produce a double-stranded cut in the DNA. These cuts are of two types. One is blunt end and another one is sticky end. In blunt end, there will be a straight cut, whereas in the sticky end, we will find a overhangs in the DNA fragment. Blunt end, these blunt end fragment can join to any other DNA fragment with a blunt end. Enzyme useful for certain type of DNA cloning experiment. Whereas in case of sticky end, the DNA fragment with complementary sticky end can be combined to create a new molecule which allows the creation and manipulation of DNA sequence from different source. Type 1 restriction endonuclease. Type 1 restriction enzyme are complex endonucleases and have recognition sequence of 15 base pair. They cleave the DNA about 1000 base pair away from the 5 prime end of the sequence. TCA located, this is TCA means the base pairs, you know, thymine, cytosine, adenine, located within the recognition site. Example is ECOK12. Or ECOB, etc. The type 1 restriction enzyme work with the help of many cofactors like S-adenosylmethionine, hydrolyzed adenosine triphosphate, and magnesium. The type 1 restriction enzyme methylates the DNA sequence at the site of recognition. The type 1 restriction enzyme translocate the DNA sequence. Type 1 restriction enzyme possesses 3 subunit: HSDR required for restriction, HSDM necessary for adding methyl group to host DNA, that is methyl transferase activity, HSDS important for specificity of cut site recognition in the addition to its methyl transferase activity. Type 2 restriction endonucleases. The type 2 restriction enzymes are remarkably stable and induce cleavage either in most cases within or outside their recognition sequence, which are symmetrical. The type 2 restriction enzyme work with the help of a single cofactor like magnesium. Type 2 restriction endonucleases. The first type of type 2 enzyme to be isolated from HEND2 in 1970. The only type 2 restriction endonuclease are used for restriction mapping and gene cloning in view of their cleavage only at specific site. Cut off type 2 restriction endonucleases. The type 2 restriction enzyme can generate two different type of cuts depending on whether they've cut both the strand at the center of the recognition sequence. The former cut will generate blunt end with no nucleotide overhang, whereas the later generate a sticky end or a cohesive end. Subunits of type 2 restriction endonucleases. These subgroups are defined using a letter suffix. Type 2B restriction enzyme and type 2 T restriction enzyme, whereas type E restriction endonucleases and even the type 2 M endonucleases, restriction endonucleases. So this is the difference. Type E and M are represented as restriction endonucleases, whereas type 2 B it is type 2 B and type 2 T has been represented as restriction enzymes. Type 3 restriction endonucleases. Type 3 restriction enzymes are intermediate between type 1 and type 2 endonucleases. They cleave DNA in the immediate vicinity of the recognition site. Example is ECOP1, ECOP15, HIND3, etc. They cut DNA up to 20 to 30 base pair away from the recognition site. These enzymes contain more than one subunit, that is ATP and magnesium chloride, and require adomate and ATP cofactor for their role in DNA methylation and restriction. Type 4 restriction endonucleases. They cleave only normal and modified DNA, methylated, hydroxymethylated and glycoxyhydroxymethylated base. Recognition sequence have not been well defined. Cleavage takes place 30 base pair away from one site. Nomenclature of restriction enzyme depend on the genus, species, strain and order of isolation. Like for example, ECOR1 has been isolated from the bacterium Escherichia coli with the strain R and order isolated was 1. So the first letter from the genus, that is E, was retained and it should be written in a capital letter, whereas the species first two letters has been taken and that should be represented in a small letter, and the strain name, first letter of the strain, if it is in a capital letter, the capital letter will be retained, or if it is in a small letter, then that will be retained. Like in case of HIND3, the strain was D, small d. So that was retained in the naming of restriction enzyme. And the order of isolation. This enzyme was isolated in first enzyme which has been isolated from the Escherichia coli. So the order was 1. So ECOR1. Whereas in case of HIND3, it was isolated from Haemophilus influenza, so H from the genus and IN from the species, and strain was D, small d, so that was retained, and order was 3, so that is the third enzyme isolated from the Haemophilia influenza. Whereas in case of BAM H1, it was isolated from Bacillus amylo, so B from the genus, AM from the species, H from the strain and I from the order of one from the order of isolation. The recognition sequence of restriction enzyme. The recognition sequence of type 2 endonucleases form palindrome with rotational symmetry. The type 2 endonucleases have a recognition site of 4, 5 or 6 base pair which are predominantly GC rich, which are predominantly GC rich. Properties of restriction enzyme. If we take all three restriction enzyme, that is 1, 2 and 3, the nature of enzyme consists of both endonuclease and methylase activity in the same enzyme, whereas in case of both type 1 and type 3 show endonuclease and methylase activity in one unit itself, whereas in case of type 2 restriction enzyme, separate endonuclease and methylase activity will be seen. So the protein structure have a three different subunit. In case of type 2, it is two identical subunit. Here three different subunit, whereas in type 2 restriction enzyme it has a two identical subunit, whereas in case of type 3, two different subunit. Here two identical, but here two different subunit. Restriction requirement like ATP, magnesium chloride, S-adenosyl, adenosyl methionine, whereas in case of type 2 it will be magnesium, only magnesium chloride is required, only magnesium is required, whereas in type 3 ATP plus magnesium ions are required. Cleavage site, random and up to 1000 base pair away from the restriction site. Whereas type 1 restriction enzyme, it will be like AT or near the recognition site, where the AT region will be there. There it will going to cleave the restriction site. And then in case of type 3 restriction enzyme, the cleavage site will be 24 to 26 base pair 3 prime 2 restriction site. So here the random up to 1000 base pair away from the restriction site, but here it will be 80 or near to the restriction site. And whereas in case of type 3, it will be 24 to 26 base pair 3 prime to the restriction site. Example is ECO-B for type 1, and type 2 it will be ECO-R1. And for type 3, example is ECO-P1. Application of restriction enzymes. They are used in gene cloning and protein expression experiment. Restriction enzymes are used in biotechnology to cut the DNA into small strand in order to study fragment length difference among the individual. Example is the restriction fragment length polymorphism, which is also represented as RFLP. Each of these methods depend on the use of agarose gel electrophoresis for separation of DNA fragment. Provide different ways for manipulating DNA, such as the creation of recombinant DNA, which has endless application. Allow for the large scale production of human insulin for diabetes using E. coli, as well as for the hepatitis B and HPV vaccine. Cloning DNA molecules, studying nucleotide sequence. These are the applications of restriction enzyme.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.